This video will show you how to make a sword on Roblox. Insert parts using the part button and design your sword to your liking. We're going to design a simple sword using parts and wedge parts. Once you've finished creating your sword, insert a part and name it Handle. Make sure it has a capital H and scale the part down to be small. Move your handle to where you want the player to hold your sword. Now select all of your parts and ensure that the anchored property is set to unchecked. Click on the plus icon in the workspace and insert a tool object. Select your parts and drag them into the tool. Again, make sure that the handle part is spelt correctly and has a capital H, otherwise the tool will not work. Now we need to weld all of the parts together so that the sword doesn't fall apart. Click the plus icon on the handle and insert a weld constraint. Set the part 0 property to the handle and set the part 1 property to one of the other parts. Repeat this step until you've set up weld constraints which connect the handle to every other part. Make sure part 0 is the handle on every weld. Now ensure that your sword is the correct size relative to a Roblox character. You can do this by inserting an NPC character via the plugins Rig Builder menu, or by inserting an NPC from the toolbox. Change the size of your sword by selecting the tool object, then by selecting the scale tool. Name your sword by selecting the tool and changing the name property in the properties panel. Drag the sword into the starter pack and then click the play button. Select your sword in the toolbar to equip it. If your sword is not rotated correctly, close the test session, select the handle again, and then press Ctrl plus R or Command plus R on Mac to rotate by 90 degrees. Now that we've created our sword, we can script it to kill other players. Insert a script into the tool. Inside this script, we are writing code to kill the player. We detect when the sword touches another object, check to make sure it's a player or NPC, and if so, we deduct health from their humanoid, which will kill them. We also add their character to a debounce table for 2 seconds to ensure that there's a cooldown for the script. You can find this code by going to the link in the description. Select a part and duplicate it. Then use the scale tool to make it cover the area of the sword which we don't hold. This will be the part which detects touches from players that the sword hits. Set the transparency of the hitbox to 1. And then duplicate a weld constraint in the handle and set the part 1 to the hitbox. You can test your sword by inserting an NPC into the game via the toolbox or rig builder. Then walk up to the NPC and touch the sword against it. The NPC should be killed. Now you can go back and select your handle and set its transparency to 1.